Meantime, two firefighters were injured when a plane crashed and then exploded today. That happened at the Oroville airport this morning. The people on the plane escaped, but it was the firefighters responding who were burned. KCRA3's Tom Duhane joins us live. Tom?
Well, the firefighters here were saved by their protective gear, and authorities are telling us the two people on the plane, a plane very similar to the one right behind me, a small Piper aircraft, they're lucky to be alive after their plane crashed just after takeoff. This is what's left of a single-engine Piper Cherokee after it crashed and burned near the main runway in Oroville about 11 a.m. The two occupants, a man and a woman, escaped with minor injuries. And according to
another pilot that was putting his aircraft away over at the hangar heard sputtering. He said he knew there was engine trouble, and then he looked and he saw it start to make a bank to try to come back towards the runway.
Flames from the plane caused a small brush fire. As two Oroville firefighters approached, the plane's fuel tank exploded, sending out a fireball.
The explosion happened. It engulfed their upper bodies in flames.
The firefighters were rushed to the UCD Medical Center in Sacramento. They were examined and will be released shortly with only relatively minor burns. Names of the pilot and passenger have not yet been released, although the FAA says the flight originated in Woodland. And we're back live now again. That is what we think is a very similar model to the plane that crashed and burned earlier here today. Again, the names of the passengers from Woodland have not yet been released. We do have the names of the firefighters, though. Captain John Weber of the Oroville Fire Department and Marcus Perez. Marcus Perez suffered more burns in the facial area than his captain did. Marcus is an intern, a fire intern, just learning his craft. Today he learned a valuable lesson. All that protective gear and the breathing apparatus does save your life. In Oroville, Tom Duhane, KCRA 3 reports. Yeah.